Today's lesson is about two words, much and many. So we're going to talk about something that many of my students get wrong a lot of the time. So here are the differences between much, many, lot of, lots of. So firstly, note that the last one are the same thing. A lot of, lots of, and you can use them interchangeably. C'est-à-dire que pour a lot of et lots of, on peut les utiliser et les permuter comme bon nous semble, alors que ce n'est pas le cas pour much et many. Which is not the case for much and many. So I'm going to explain how to use them right now. Let's jump up to the new slide. So, you need to know what is an uncountable noun and a countable noun. Les fameux indénombrables et dénombrables. Et c'est ce qui va déterminer le fonctionnement de much and many. With uncountable nouns, this refers to something that cannot be counted. And they don't have plural forms, as it were. But as always, there are some exceptions. So uncountable means indénombrable, les choses qu'on ne peut pas compter. Donc ça fonctionnera avec les noms qui n'ont pas de forme au pluriel, c'est-à-dire là on n'ajoute pas un S par exemple. A l'inverse, vous avez les dénombrables où les noms pourront se transformer et prendre la forme du pluriel en ajoutant un petit S, comme dog qui devient dogs. Orange qui devient oranges, tree qui devient trees. Uncountable nouns go with much. With liquids, we usually use much because liquids are uncountable, like water, oil, milk, honey. Paper is uncountable too, so we do not say two papers. We're going to say two sheets of papers. It's like the word rice. We're not going to say two rices. No. So there are several words like this, which are uncountable. And I'm going to give you a list of these words so you can learn them and avoid making mistakes. Countable. Countable go with many. You see this word, many? You can use it with affirmative, negative, and interrogative. So, for example, with dogs, I have three dogs. Actually, I wish I had them. Second word, orange. I have so many oranges. I have many oranges. J'ai beaucoup d'oranges. With trees. There are so many beautiful trees. I love nature. It is so rejuvenating to spend some quality time, don't you think? Much can sound incredibly formal. But what does it mean, formal? Formal means formel. Formel, c'est-à-dire un peu strict, protocolaire. À l'inverse, vous avez le mot informal. Informal, familier, plutôt plus détendu. If I say, I have much milk. Oula, it sounds like I'm a policeman officer. This is a little bit too much. We would rather say in the affirmative, I have a lot of milk. So, on the other hand, many is widely used with the affirmative. You could say, I have many oranges. I have a lot of oranges. I don't know. I have a lot of pineapples, apples, whatever you want. Last one is about a lot of, lots of. So, as you can see, you can either use these words with uncountable or countable nouns. Donc, pour ces deux mots, vous pouvez les utiliser que ce soit avec des noms indénombrables ou dénombrables. Donc, il n'y a pas de problème. Okay, that's all, folks.
I hope you liked it.
Thanks for listening. I'll see you all later.